In episode 4 of season 2, Keeping Up Appearances, we learn some extremely interesting information. Spoiler warning, obviously. According to Gwendolyn, Ida's mother, there's a substance called Titan's Blood which causes leaks between the human and demon realms. Many years ago, another human found himself in Bonesboro through one of these leaks. He lived there for a while before one day mysteriously disappearing, only leaving something behind in the library. Here's why this human is definitely 100% Emperor Belos. Before I get into it though, a lot of you guys are watching my Owl House theories, and that's awesome. However, not many of you are subscribing. Hitting subscribe would not only make sure you don't miss out on my latest videos, but also drastically help out the channel. If you're feeling extra generous and want to put some food on my table while you're at it, support me on Patreon for some awesome perks. The link is in the description. Now, back to the video.
Knock, knock, human.
Let's approach this by first taking a look at the most obvious evidence. In episode 1, a lying witch and a warden were introduced to the Conformatorium. It's run by Emperor Belos himself and serves as a prison to contain anything or anyone he finds unacceptable. While it may seem insignificant at first, there's a huge hint this place gives us that suggests he's human. So, Ida requests Luce's help to retrieve King's Burger Queen crown from the Conformatorium for one specific reason. Only a human can pass the barrier where the contraband is kept. This is highly suspicious, right? The only human on the Isles, as far as we're aware of, is Luce. So why would only a human be able to pass through the barrier? I mean, hell, even the henchmen aren't human. Why would Emperor Belos make it this way? You know what I'm getting at. The only logical conclusion is that Belos himself is human and made it this way so only he can access the contraband.
You think you're so smart!
So if Belos really is human, why the glowing eyes? Why the unstable physical form? Trust me, I have an answer. The coded message in Keeping Up Appearances was puppet. While many believe it relates to Creepy Luce for obvious reasons, I myself actually believe it refers to Belos. Why? Because he pretty much admits it himself. He calls himself a messenger of the Titan, meaning the Titan speaks through him. To add yet another twist to this already twisty theory, I don't think that the Titan is his true puppet master. Instead, I think it's a much more nefarious entity that's possessing him. Specifically, it's whatever the hell we see emerging from him in this scene, from the season 2 trailer. And it makes a ton of sense if Belos is being partially manipulated. Belos's voice actor himself said he was misunderstood. This may seem somewhat random, but there's a huge reason why I believe this dude has nothing to do with the Titan. You know, outside of Belos being just about the world's most untrustworthy person.
I will not be healing her.
But you promised me.
Belos is very anti-wild magic, and even went as far as to eradicate all beings who practice it. This is extremely bizarre for someone who claims to be a messenger for the Titan to do, seeing as wild magic is literally gifted to witches by the Titan. Let me explain. In episode 12, Adventures in the Elements, Ida says she's studying wild magic. She claims that witches of old would draw upon the natural magic of a place called the Knee to learn how to cast spells. This is why Ida spends all episode trying to get Luce to be in touch with nature. Guys, it's called the Knee because it's the goddamn knee of the Titan. Luce is literally learning how to communicate with it. When the glyphs reveal themselves to her, that's literally the Titan teaching her magic. Kikimora's story about wild magic being insulting to the Titan is total BS.
Oh, who's the liar now, Augustus?
But still, why go as far as to abolish wild magic and claim that it's evil? I believe that Belos was never able to make the connection to the Titan that Luce and other wild witches did. Why? While I don't think he was always evil, maybe the Isles didn't deem him worthy due to having a heart highly susceptible to evil. Because, you know, we know that turned out to be pretty damn true. Either way, his inability to use wild magic made him fear it, leading to the current circumstance. So if his magic doesn't come from the Titan, and where does it even come from? As some of you have probably noticed, Belos' staff is very techie. It lacks a talisman and instead seems entirely artificial. I mean, the damn thing even has a wire on it. Come on. This baby is powered by technology. I don't believe Belos has his own magic and that it comes entirely from this staff. Here's why. First of all, you may argue that we see him use magic without his staff, but do we really? There are two scenes where he allegedly uses magic with his his hands and not his staff. But during those scenes, I've noticed that he still always has his staff on him. He, for some reason, deliberately conceals his staff inside his cape while casting magic with his hands. And I imagine he does this specifically to sell the illusion that he has power without it. He wouldn't want anybody knowing he's secretly powerless, right?
What are you gonna do? We all know you're powerless now.
And let's not forget, Luce was wearing a witch's wool cape. Just in case you forgot, its sole function is to protect against powerful spells. Why was it completely ineffective against Belos? Simple, he doesn't use magic. Instead, I believe the power his staff generates is some form of artificial magic. We even see Belos' heavy reliance on science in Season 2. He not only buys Blight Industries' entire stock of abomatons, but plans to upgrade them himself. He may not be a wizard, but he does appear to be a wizard at science. Alright, so let's address the elephant in the room. Why is this dude's favourite drink palisman juice? There's actually a pretty obvious explanation for this. Gwendolyn states that her great-grandmother was the one who told her about the human who used to live in Bonesborough. If this human really was Belos, that makes him pretty damn old. And in case you haven't noticed, his body seems to be rotting. This could definitely be down to his age.
We will never be afraid of you, you old creep!
Perhaps for Belos to carry on living, as well as for the host to carry on using him, he needs to extend his own life force by absorbing the life force of a palisman. Finally, why would this thing possess Belos in particular? Not being able to do magic himself, perhaps he was preyed upon in a vulnerable state and promised everything by this entity. Maybe he told Belos that if he helped him achieve the Day of Unity, they'd both unlock magical power beyond their wildest dreams. Of course, I don't think he would have been manipulated if he didn't have any talents of his own. Being a human, Belos may have had a penchant for science back on Earth. Apparently, he even likes libraries. He could have been some kind of genius learning to create weapons such as his staff with materials found in the demon realm. So, do I have any ideas about what the evil entity is? Personally, I have a strong feeling it might be the thing we see King's dad fight in the carvings. Maybe after losing that fight, all that was left was his heart, and so he needed a body. I always thought it was a bit too small to be the Titans. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I'd really appreciate it if you gave it a like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe for more awesome theories. Do you think Emperor Belos is human? Comment with your thoughts and theories down below. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.